Hey everybody, we are cooking up some down home goodness today. We're going to be making some fried apples, southern fried apples. And I'll tell you, they're even better than that restaurant that always has them on their menu. And we're starting off with a fourth of a cup of unsalted butter, half a cup of firmly packed brown sugar, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, and about a fourth of a teaspoon of salt. So we've got our butter and sugar and cinnamon in here. And we're just gonna melt the butter, melt the sugar, and it's gonna make somewhat of a syrup. You know, Southerners get a bad rap for frying everything. Well, somebody tell me a cuisine that does not include frying. That's what I thought. There is none. They all fry. This actually is not even fried, it's more sauteed. But I can assure you, saute was not in the vocabulary of my people. If you cooked it in butter over high heat, it was fried. And that's what we're doing here. All right, so we've got butter, we've got brown sugar, we've got cinnamon, we've got a little bit of salt. Now the other ingredient that you need to add to this, just to maintain a balance, is something with acidity. You can either use apple cider vinegar or you can use lemon juice, about a tablespoon of each. I tossed my apples with lemon juice, so I'm not gonna add any additional acidity. I think I've got enough in here. I've got 6 apples. I've got a couple of different varieties. You choose whatever you like. I think I've got Honeycrisp and Gala here. And these are gonna go into our brown sugar mixture. And then you wanna stir until all the apples are coated with this mixture. So as these apples cook down, they're gonna release some of their juices, their apple juice, back into this brown sugar cinnamon mixture here. And they're basically gonna make apple cinnamon syrup. There's nothing wrong with that. And that's why this tastes so good. I know I've seen copycat recipes of Cracker Barrel's fried apple recipe, and they add some thickener to the brown sugar mixture. And you can do that if you like, but I like for this, I like more of a syrupy consistency with the brown sugar than for it to be thick. So now, get them all coated. And this does not take long to cook. Probably about 10 minutes. You just want them to be fork tender. You don't want the apples to be mushy. I don't want the apples to be mushy. You can cook the apples however you like them, but I don't want them to be mushy. So they need to cook for about 10 minutes, like this. Stir occasionally, and then we'll test for goodness. And here they are bubbling away. And here we've got a skillet full of southern fried apples, ready to be served. I hope now that you see how easy this recipe is. I mean, there's nothing to it. Nothing to it. Comes together quick, you cook it fast, and you serve it up, and it's delicious. Thank you so much for joining in today. Get this recipe and others at serpentbiscuits.com. God bless you. Y'all come see us.